I was the biggest stand-up comic this world had ever seen. Was it controversial? Yeah. Long story short, my career goes in the toilet. Now, I'm coming out of retirement, and I'm gonna film the whole damn thing. I'm taking along my family, and that's my friends, my crew. They're idiots. I'm gonna shake the world again, whether you like it or not. You hear? Oh! Unbelievable. It's not easy just filming yourself, you know what I mean?
I'm not looking in the mirror. The mirror's over there. I'm looking in the viewfinder of a camera. That's where I'm going. Look, this is the deal. In the late 80s, I became the biggest stand-up comic this world has ever seen.
I was everywhere. I was on television. I was in movies. I
had gold and platinum albums. It was rock and roll comedy.
Was that controversial? Yeah. The media loved it. They couldn't get enough of my bad boy act. And then it turned. I became the lightning rod for everything PC. People would look at me like, oh, it's him.
Who, after 1990, will remember who Andrew Dice Clay was?
Make a long story short, my career went into the toilet. And years later, so did my marriage.
So what did I do? I started filming my own life, even though nobody asked me to. In a way, it's like therapy, you know what I mean?
And I laid low. I got rid of the managers, the publicists, the agents, and I took care of my sons. Max and Dylan.
And then there's my fiance, Eleanor. I mean, can you believe it? I actually got a fiance. And I love them with my whole heart, okay? So you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna blow this whole thing up again.
I'm sick and tired of living in my own shadow. And the time feels right. People are pissed off, just like they were in the late 80s. They need a comic hero. I'm gonna put myself back in those arenas. I'm gonna see just how big I could become again.
Here he is for you tonight, Andrew Dice Clay!
Oh! Unbelievable.
Sleeping through this? Yes, Sandra. You gotta get up. You gotta get up.
This is the thing about Eleanor. It takes a special kind of girl to put up with me. I'm from Brooklyn. She's from South Philly. She was an ex-female wrestler.
You are dead meat!
She ain't no pushover. She's adorable. I mean, I love this girl. Oh, look how cute you are.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You're really not as ugly as everybody says.
Andrew, get out of here.
I'm just trying to be nice.
Funny.
I'm just being nice.
Well, be nice somewhere else.
No, Vinny, what I like is that you got the low ceilings and you, the audience is right on top of you.
All you do is an audience.
I'll call you a day before I come. Goodbye.
Please stop saying that.
What is going on here? Just had a great jam session and you're at each other's throats. What's wrong with you?
It's just annoying.
All right, well, please, stop being annoying. But you did. You sounded great today, both of you.
You sounded fantastic. I can't believe it.
Maybe we could come to, like, the Stress Factory with you and do some stuff.
Oh, do you hear? Why don't we just not go to school at all?
Well, it's on the weekend, so...
No. It's across the country. It's a small club.
Right now, I'm in a good mood about getting back on stage. You really got to start somewhere. To go back home and play this club, the Stress Factory. Perfect name. It's... going back to my roots, those New York roots.
All right, keep practicing. You gotta make some calls. What, babe?
I gotta get out of here. I gotta go meet Cynthia.
You going now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wanted you to throw the garbage out with us.
I gotta go.
All right. Sit close.
I don't think I'm getting close, Andrew.
Wheels, please. Make like you're my date. Look at it.
I know, it's kind of creepy.
My camera will call. This is the A camera, and that's the B camera.
All right.
So you see that you could see me better here now? But if I bring the window up a little, it's like I had to teach myself how to film.
Yeah, lighting.
Yeah, I had to fix the lighting.
So I talked to Vinny at the Stress Factory. We went over everything.
I gotta get some answers from you. We're leaving soon.
Wheels, we're not leaving for over a week.
But I know that. I want it to run smooth, that's all.
No, I know. I know. And you're doing a great job.
So, what's going on with you guys? You know.
What do you mean, what's going on?
Are you guys gonna tie the knot? Get married.
Wheels, I just got out of 16 years of marriage. We're engaged.
To get married.
The minute you're together a little while and dating, that's when it's fun. When you know this is fresh, they only push it. Let's get engaged. Then she becomes your fiance. I don't even know what that word means. Anybody ever look it up anywhere? No, it's just fancy. It's fancy for it's half over for you.
This is an important gig. What do you mean you can't go?
I didn't realize I had these bookings with Cannoli Kings. I have catering jobs I gotta do all
Wheels, time. You're supposed to open the show, you're supposed to road manage.
And I really want to do it.
Where are you gonna get the road manager?
Maybe Todd can do it. Todd can probably do it. I don't see why he can't do it. He'll do what he's got to do.
That's what you're saying.
As much as I can run the phone and work with Todd and work with the hotels and stuff.
You can work with Todd.
I can make like I'm there, but I'm not going to be physically there. So you can get somebody to open for you. There's a lot of acts out there.
Dylan would be a better road manager than Todd. I need her to call. The one day I need you to have a phone. You don't have a phone. What do you give me? Who are you on the phone with? That's so important that you walk out.
It's not that important, but my friend Nikki called.
What friend Nikki?
My friend Nikki from Philly. I know I told you about him before. Anyway, he called.
It's not your friend. It's an ex-boyfriend.
The fact that Eleanor spoke to an old boyfriend really bothers me. I mean, the old me would have ended it right there and then. But it's not that easy when you're in love with somebody.
That'll be fun.
I don't know.
Hold on a second. Okay, so change the soap. You know what? Let me call you right back. You can't change the soap?
Changing it.
Thank you.
I know it's too hard for you to do.
I know.
It's a simple task, so why
not?
I know.
What is
wrong with you?
Nothing.
Okay. Thank you.
You know, how long has the soap been empty?
How do I know?
Well, if you weren't on the phone 24 hours a day.
I got three pots going here. She called. I answered.
But did you wash your hands when you
yes, before. Maybe I used the end of it.
I know, to you it's funny.
You know why it's funny? Because you're arguing with me over soap.
I'll change the soap.
You already did.
You know what? I'll change girlfriends. How's that sound?
What's wrong with you?
You know what? Forget it.
What? You start something, you can't finish it?
There's nothing to finish. I don't want to get mad.
You already mad! You don't just come down there and start a fight with me for no reason.
I think
Andrew,
that's fun for me to know that an old boyfriend called you. You don't get it. That's why there's a problem, okay?
Oh, there's
then,
a problem.
Then you know what? Wear
Such
his ring, all right?
You know what? Fine.
Don't wear
I
mine.
I will have
okay?
it. I'll wear his ring.
All right?
Absolutely. Have a good time
ring.
In Jersey.
You know what? Thank God you didn't have to sit listening to her about all the baggage she's now going to bring to this relationship. Who cares what happened with all the old boyfriends? You know she's going to yell at you? He was an ass. like you're not a future ass to this girl.
In New York, here we come. The worst
you know
road
that.
Manager the in the history of the United
oh,
States
really?
Of America.
Really?
Dice!
I can't take this dressing room. I feel like I'm in a cage.
Are you ready?
There's my Max waking up for another
fun day at school, right? Give me a kiss. I gotta go. I gotta go. I'm only filming you because they tell me to do it.
Alright.
You know what I mean? Unbelievable. This is how I gotta leave my house. Here we are, Newark Airport. We're heading towards the baggage claim. Where's my bag? All right, get it. Let's go.
I'll get this.
Let's go.
You get this thing. You get that.
Get that.
I'll get this.
Watch what you're doing.
Just gotta find the limo guy. Okay, first problem. Our limo driver isn't here at the airport. Todd told me it's all handled. The worst load manager in the history of the United States of America.
Really?
Mr. Road Manager. Mr. I couldn't find a handle on a coffee cup. I'm on my way to Dennis Offer. He's been my agent for the last 18 years. He saw me when I was doing the Rodney Dangerfield special, Nothing Goes Right. He was there at that taping, and he's been my agent ever since.
Here you go.
Okay, thank you.
You know, I can't, you know, I got a problem with clubs. You want to play clubs? What could I tell you?
Since divorce and everything, I got to do what I have to do to pay the bills.
I understand.
You know, this is a new start. This is like coming out of retirement, you know what I mean? And I'm ready to go. It's new material, but it still has my voice, you know what I mean? It's getting going again. That's why I wanted to talk to you, because this might sound crazy to you, but do you remember when you called me up and you said, you want to cross the street? Meaning going into Giant Stadium. Well, you know, that was a time I knew I couldn't do that. It wasn't that I couldn't fill it, but mentally I couldn't handle it. But I feel it's unfinished business. And I think with the right moves, we can take it to that level.
I think that's a great goal. What are you talking about doing this?
I think we have to obviously build. I mean, we couldn't go on sale today and sell our Giant Stadium.
I would love to sell you dice, you know, however. I want you to have dreams, but there's a difference between dreams and fantasies.
Yeah, but, you know, years ago, you know.
It's a long way from home, man.
This is something that, you know, you're just the one guy that,
Yeah.
Hi, I got Debbie Gibson online, too.
All right, I'll be right there. Dice, I gotta leave.
All right.
Hi, Deb. How are you? Good, where are you? Rockford, super. Big. I'm in here with a client. Can you call me in about 20 minutes? He'll be gone. I'd appreciate that. All right, I'll call you. I'll speak to you in 20. Goodbye. Debbie Gibson.
Debbie Gibson, you're saying it like it's even a person. My meeting with Dennis didn't go exactly the way I thought it should, and I think he should be a little more behind me than he is. I don't like hearing that. I it's just a fantasy. It's not good for me. I'm about ready to leave my hotel and go do my first show out in New Jersey at the Stress Factory. I'm pumped up for it, but at the same time, nervous. It's the process, I guess, I go through before every show. Time to go perform.
Do me a favor. Can you pull off the road here for a minute?
Here we are. Here we are. See, it's hard to see it exactly. But there it is. Giant Stadium. And it's not going to be easy. It's a lot of hard work. But it's going to be worth it. It's going to be worth it for my kids and my half-fiancé.
He's so blunt, he's so blatant, he don't care. That's what I like. I love that. I like hearing balls, all that. I like.
All right, so where are we?
Good evening.
and welcome.
Good evening and welcome.
Good evening.
Can you say that, like,
yeah.
You know?
Okay, ready? Good evening and welcome. Are you ready?
The undisputed heavyweight comedy king.
And then I'll say your name. And then you want me to say it first, but first, tonight's Dice is opening act.
You're not doing that.
Oh, okay,
part
that's
of the
right.
Show.
Huh?
This is my walk-on.
Well, all right, I won't do it.
One thing I ask you to do on these trips.
All right.
You make me sweat.
No, it's 95 degrees in here.
No, you do this. It's very stuffy in here. It's very tight here in claustrophobic. I can't take this dressing room. I feel like I'm in a cage.
Tom, do you feel these lights, Andrew? They're hot.
I don't know why they have lights like this.
Is that better? No. How about
I'm filming
that?
A television show. When was the last show? You know, filmed in the dark.
Okay, you're all on. Nice.
Think they'll like the suit?
And of course, Eleanor didn't call all day, but why would she? I got a show to do.
If you don't want to make up, don't make up. I don't care. You know what? You know, there's plenty of turtles around in the sea, whatever they say. Flies.
Are you ready? You is people. Having a hypoglycemic
attack. Go get away. There's always that one thing that just destroys a relationship.
That is the biggest line of I've ever heard.
Are you ready? Andrew Dice Clay! Look at her. She's cute. I so much in her mouth, it would look like her teeth are melting. I mean, who brings their chicks to a dice show and sits in the front row?
This was great, okay? This is why I came back east, to feel the crowd. This feels like 20 years ago when things were really starting to take off. Now, I'm not saying that it's not gonna be a lot of hard work. What I am saying is that what a great start.
The intro was phenomenal. I mean, no, I'm not kidding you.
Focus. Stop with the ADD.
Todd,
all right. I'm trying. This is why I get mad at you.
All right, I'm sorry.
I'm giving you a compliment.
Thank you.
It was one of the greatest things I've ever heard you do.
You didn't know it was him, right? All of a sudden, his
not
voice
at
is
all.
Booming.
I heard this strong, right? I'll tell you, exciting. Very exciting.
We'll share a sandwich. We'll get some of those well-done French fries.
Yeah,
yeah, I'm not going to go with the knish. It'll be too heavy.
How's
the
potato?
Keep having those. Heavy. I'm having soup. I love it.
I'm having a hypoglycemic attack.
Go get a waiter. Go get a waiter.
All right.
Now, let Happy Face do it.
Thank you, Happy.
Yeah.
Please.
Pass out.
I'm getting shakes. I have to eat. I haven't eaten.
All right, really. Calm down. Right. I'm the one that did the show. You've done nothing since we're here.
Oh, really?
No, the intro is great. I know this guy. You'll help us?
Oh, yeah, that's cool.
Soup. He was thinking about the blitz.
I'm a blitz.
All right, so we'll share an order of blitz. Oh, now all of a sudden you want blitz.
I like blitz.
Have a fight. The kids are home. You know, who knows what they're thinking? You know, then I got to explain it to them. It's always, whoever you're with, there's always that one thing that just destroys a relationship.
I'm married 46 years, almost 47. If I ever came home and found my wife talking to an ex anything, there'd be trouble. Now, wouldn't you say I'm secure after 46, 47 years? Am I worried about my wife going with someone else? I do not accept.
Why though?
Why? Because nobody should need anybody else if you are content and you have a good life.
But what's wrong with just like having a friend like that?
No, he doesn't understand.
Do you know what the reason is?
That's what I want to
know. I'll tell you the reason. Okay. You want me to break it down for
yes.
you? That one, somebody lays on top of you face to face and open with that. You shouldn't be friends with them when you have somebody else.
Right.
Is that blunt enough for you?
That does make sense.
There's no reason for friends after that.
They say, you know, there should never be jealousy. That is the biggest line of I've ever heard.
You know what? I don't want to talk about
it. We're just discussing
it.
You're talking like a person who's never lived through it or been through it.
What's the reason behind it?
It's control when you bring it up to
her. Lee, walk me to the door.
Excuse me, guys.
See you later.
Anytime you're ready to say something or jump to something, take a few steps back. You have someone who loves you. You hear me?
Yeah.
All right, look. Take care. Don't look for happiness. I mean, settle for happy moments, because that's all life is.
Unbelievable. Just got off the phone with my ex-agent Dennis Arthur in New York. 20 years I'm with this guy. I never left him. We've had some disagreements, but I never left him. The guy made millions from me, okay? And I'm not gonna say he's not a great agent. He earned his money. Tried to talk to me like I don't get business at all. That's how he tried to talk. Tried to talk down to me.
Put the giant stadium thing in reality. You don't do 200 people and think you're going to go do 50,000 people tomorrow.
Don't ever talk down to me. With or without him, I'll do giant stadium. Trust me on that.
You ever feel so stressed out? You just got to get out of town, you know what I mean? Little me time, little rest and relaxation, whatever they call it. Go to Florida, see my parents, see my Uncle Lee. Book a gig, that'll pay for the expenses. I mean, Wheels probably won't be able to go because he's got a lot, you know, with the Cannoli King thing. So I'll just take Todd with me. That should be all right. What are we going to eat? I'm starving. I think I'm going to get the chicken parmesan. Minestrone soup. And we need some more bread and butter.
Excuse me. Can I get some red pepper? A little crushed red.
Where's Todd?
He was supposed to... I don't know what happened to him.
Todd, where are you? He was supposed to be here for a meeting.
For the whole road. I gotta go over things with him.
Hello? What do you mean you want to sleep? It's not even late at night. What are you, 5 years old? I'm waking you when I get home. And you better answer the phone. I'm... All right. Good night, little boy. Goodbye. Schmuck. We're leaving in a couple days, and he doesn't know anything.
I know, and I got to go over the itinerary with him, because I'm not going, so I need to make sure he knows everything.
I want to blow my top 3/4 of the time I'm with him.
You're going to eat that?
I'll share it.
No, I thought you were on this big diet.
You start Monday. Like, you know, you have the... Like a big meal.
So I just thought that was a little excessive.
You already ate a couple bread rolls.
I had one roll, and I'm going to have another. If Todd told me he couldn't meet me, I wouldn't even be here. I'd be eating a can of tuna fish at home. I mean, you know, if Todd did this to anybody else, another person would never talk to him again or work with him again.
And you're doing both.
Yeah, because I really care about him, you know? He's my friend. Sick from this food already.
You ate it like it was no tomorrow, huh?
Go out with you again either.
Sorry. I'm
sorry. I really wish you would want to come with me to Florida.
I wish I could too.
And now I gotta hop onto the airport, and the lady behind the counter wants to tell me you canceled all your reservations yesterday. So I go, no, I didn't. Just start typing in again. No, you canceled all your reservations. Really? So what you're telling me is that I got up 5 o'clock this morning, packed up my bags, woke the kids, so I took all that traffic, hobbled in here to come to you to make sure I cancel my reservations? Get me on a plane!
It'd be smart, Mr. Water.
No, thanks, we're all good.
I just want to talk to you a minute. Okay. The other night, you were supposed to show up at dinner, and you didn't. You know, you're shaking your head, yes. I mean,
I remember.
I just want to make sure you got all your ducks in line and that you're ready for business.
I spoke with Wheels. I got all the details.
Yeah. Like I said, this is, you know, this is a big trip.
Yes.
Okay? I want to have a fun time, Todd. Pay attention.
Let's have fun.
We're in the plane, and I ask you for a favor, and I said, do me a favor, help my neck. I was up all night, and you can't help that?
I've got carpal tunnel.
You don't have carpal tunnel?
Oh, no?
What is wrong with you?
I can't rub your freaking neck from next door on the seat next to you, you nuts!
You exhaust me, you know that?
And what do you do to you?
Here it is. There's the Port of Miami. There's your boats, your ships, your cruisers coming in. It's wonderful.
Looks beautiful, though.
Doesn't it?
The only bad part is that the night you're doing your show, I'm doing mine, and I just won't be able to come to your show.
I didn't know that.
I'm sorry. What am I going to do? I got to make my living, too.
I'm still so very happy you're here.
Are these yours? What, are you sleeping? I need somebody that can help me. If you can't help me, I don't even want to get to know you. How's that sound? I don't even care.
Buenos dias. Okay.
Beautiful. Nice. Nah. Don't throw it that hard.
Don't go too far, man. I don't know if there's a lifeguard out here. Come over here. Nice. It's nice, I know. I should have brought swim trunks. It's all right.
Looks like the Hamptons.
Please, I can't hear your voice for a few minutes.
You were supposed to talk to Todd. You gave him the schedule, right?
No problem, Booby. I got a car. I'm lost already.
Pick up the map and look at it.
Can't believe this is where we're stuck.
I just got to sleep.
I got my gig tonight at the Improv, so I figured first I'll go check in with my father. I mean, even though Dennis was my agent, my dad, you know, has always been my advisor. I wouldn't make a move without him. I mean, the big shows, the concerts, the controversy. My father was just always there for me.
See, I don't do this in my house. I just hang a few things, Dad.
Yeah.
I mean, where's the first 8x10 even?
Copacabana. That's where that first shot was.
That was like a big throw, right, Dad?
It was wonderful. Are you kidding?
This picture here.
Yeah.
I'm about 23, 24. Yeah.
He was a beautiful man.
You are. I don't know. My girlfriend thinks I'm pretty handsome. Huh? I always tell people, even to this day, I come to my father for advice.
Yeah. I try anyway.
Yeah. You know, I just told you that thing that happened with Dennis a little while
ago. Yeah.
We're not working together.
Right.
I really didn't want to leave him out of this part of my life.
Right.
Because
like him very much.
Yeah, I love him. I said, Dennis, I want you standing next to me when I go on stage at Giant Stadium. His vision was having me in 500-seat rooms, not arenas, and I let him go.
That's the way he operated, Dennis.
But, you know, it was insulting to me. Yeah. You know, the whole...
I know it was. I know.
You know, I mean, a lot of people, they ask me, forget about even doing a place like Madison Square Garden.
Right.
Why do you think you're going to fill a football stadium?
Because you have it inside of you. And I think you can do it. Believe me.
I know.
You will be the greatest again.
What are you doing?
Hey, what are you doing here? What's going on? What are you doing here?
I'm not booked.
No, you're not booked at the Improv.
You're kidding me, right?
Definitely not performing here tonight.
How the does that happen?
Well, this must be a mess up. with your entourage or something like that, or your camp, because if we were going to do a show together, I would have had, you know, everything ready for you. If you want to go up in front of Tosh, you can go up in front of Daniel Tosh, but it's not been...
I don't get it.
Look, I'm sorry. There's nothing I can do.
All right, I'll talk to you. Todd, come here. What the f*** is going on here?
Clue,
what do you mean? You
no
don't
clue.
Have a clue.
I had no clue.
Did you talk to Wheels?
Yes.
Didn't you set everything up?
Set everything up.
All just right. Go over there a second. Wheels.
Yeah.
I want to know why I'm in Miami and I'm not working. I just want you to answer that for me, okay? You were supposed to talk to Todd. You gave him the schedule, right?
Todd's there. I'm not there. He's supposed to be answering this.
Goodbye. Todd, get me out of here. Wheels.
You make me feel so young. You make me feel a spring is sprung. And every time I see you grin, I'm such a happy individual. The moment that you see, I wanna go play hide and seek. I wanna go and bounce the moon just like a toy balloon.
I gotta admit that I really got up from not having the gig here. I gotta admit that. If I didn't say it, then me up. I'd be lying. Todd, he's got something going on for me in Orlando. I'm just gonna go with it. Now I gotta drive to the swamplands of Orlando.
But you know, I always have a contingency plan lined up for you.
I'll drive.
You drive.
It's a good gig.
It's a good gig. Isn't this good?
Very good.
All right. Did I tell you about my dream I had last night about Fidel Castro?
This place better be good, and it better be a good gig. How did you...
I am your point, man. Nobody can top me.
Todd, pay attention.
Gotcha.
Pay focus when I talk to you.
Okay.
How did you get me a gig?
That's my business. Don't you worry.
Uh-huh.
This is the team man you're doing with you. I'm Titanium, remember? Titanium Todd. All right, we'll get there.
Just read the map. I want to get there. I want to sleep. I want to relax. I feel like we're driving cross country.
I'm lost already.
Pick up the map and look at it.
All right, let me see.
Fool.
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 Fool. Fool.
Hey, guys. Hey, Pally. I think we're going to go a couple of miles up ahead. It says the Golden Link Inn on this
The
map.
Golden right Link Inn?
Let's do it.
Link my balls.
Right there.
That's it?
Let's check in. Let's get a spot. All right, pull right in over here. Hi. I think I already have a reservation here.
Okay.
Because I just called up. Okay.
Can you put our rooms near each other?
Yeah, keep us together, like next to each other.
Todd, what room is it?
It's 302. This is the closest to the gig. Tomorrow, you'll be happy I got us here.
It's a house.
Wait, 302. This way.
Which way? It's a 402.
Hold on a second here. Let me go on the other side.
Todd, I'm not going to keep going up and downstairs.
Down here. Three is on this side.
What room is down there?
408. There's no 302. It goes from 102 to 402. To 202. We got to go over there. We're going to get in the car and drive right there.
It's a different hotel.
And...
What?
Down here.
Why did you have me upstairs when it's down here?
Look how beautiful that lake is. You know how stunning that is going to be in the morning?
It's swamp.
Someone's on. There we go. Beautiful. Now we're going to have to put some AC on. We're keeping it real, and I don't want to hear any complaints.
The TV don't work. I can't believe this is where we're stuck. It, like, reminds me, like, when I started out in comedy.
Yeah.
Like, all those years, like, just banging around comedy clubs.
Yeah.
Like, you know, they would say, you know, we'll fly in, we'll put you up, you know, and it would be in, like, little places like this.
Right.
But you were thrilled to do it. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Look at this. Hit the ceiling. Can you do that? That's hard to do. Will you hit the ceiling with it? So you're really into this girl.
Love her.
That's who that guy was. He was trying to save everybody.
Holden Caulfield.
Yeah.
Like that? You meet someone... You fall for them, they fall for you. There's a connection. It's two heavenly spirits that meet into a cosmic union of of whatever you want it to be.
Talking to you really is not worth talking.
I'm burnt out. I haven't done one show yet. I have to get ready.
Don't be nasty to me.
Don't let me get up on the wrong side of the bed.
Do you know anything about what I've been through? I hate to say it. I might have to send them back to L.A. It's really great that he was able to get me a gig in Orlando after the botch job in Miami. But what he puts me through and the aggravation I've been through in just a couple days with him is just tremendous.
Read the map. I want to get there.
I'm trying to stay cool and I really got to think about it because we've been friends for a long time. But I might have to, I hate to say it, I might have to send him back to L.A.
You're taking more money from me for this trip than other trips.
I'm finally getting what I deserve.
How come I flew to Florida? What's your job?
Don't worry about what I do.
What's your job?
Just don't worry about it.
You didn't even show up the other night. No responsibility.
You gotta close your yap because you're getting on my nerves.
That's what you did.
I'm a real road manager, and that's what I'm getting paid for.
Don't, and do me a favor, don't be nasty to me.
And you don't be nasty to me.
Don't let me get up on the wrong side of the bed. I got two shows I got to do tonight.
Then don't be nasty to me.
I got two shows.
I know that.
Todd,
don't be nasty to me.
I'm not nasty.
Okay.
You got nasty to me right away.
What I do?
Do you know anything about what I've been through?
I know your business is a pain.
We're done. You're fired. That's it.
Okay.
Goodbye, Todd.
Whatever.
You need a friend like me, but you lost him. Goodbye, Don. I'm Todd.
Bye, potty mouth. What is this? East I-92. Yeah, is there a service here that can pick me up and take me to the airport? I need a car service. Get me at where the hell? I-92 at the Super Todd. 8 Motel.
Todd!
Yeah, there's a Super 8 Motel.
Meet Get in the car, come on.
I want a car service to pick me up now at the Super 8 Motel.
Come on now.
Oh, so now that, what do you mean?
Come on. What do you want, to fight all day?
I'll get a car service and I'll walk.
Come in the car now.
For what? You said what you had to say.
And you said what you had. Come
That's
on,
right.
Let's make up now. Come on. Come on. Come on, look at you. Come on.
I love you, Dicey, but I'm telling you right now.
And I love you.
Don't treat me like the other guys. You treat me like them, it's we got problems.
Who's your best friend?
You.
Here, let me. Come on.
Hey, crazy.
Come on, look at me. Look at me. Who wants you in this?
I don't know. I've been watching Ned Dice Clay since I was about 13 years old. He is by far the funniest comic I've ever seen.
Dice! Awesome, man!
Hello!
This is the smallest dressing room. Another that's in the middle of nowhere. Yeah, Dad. Yeah, we're at the club. That's all right. The dressing room's small. No, it's going to be great. It is going great. Dad, I'm telling you. I'm going to shake the world again. You know that. You know how I am. All right, say hello to Mom for me, and I love you. You know that, okay? All right, bye.
headliner tonight? That's what I'm talking about. This is New York's Bad Boy. This guy sold out the Garden in 30 minutes. Give it up for the Dice Man, Andrew Dice Clay.
Headline guy.
I'm still a headline guy. You know what I mean?
For a while you popped out, now you're coming back. Let's talk a little bit about where your career has been.
I can't even believe it.
You were running a gym. Tell us about that.
Running a gym?
Weren't you running a gym at some point?
You're supposed to be a news guy. Where are you getting your
Star research? You weren't. You weren't.
This is ridiculous. Every time I do an interview, a guy wants to open his mouth.
All right, Andrew.
Do a little
very much. We thought that you could hold back.
Yourself. You know what?
All right.
I'll admit. Sometimes I lose my cool. Why? I'm hard to deal with. I'm a comedian. Why am I the only guy banned from MTV for life? I mean, they got murderers on that channel. Look, it's been 10 years since I've done my stand-up on television, and I just booked the Showtime special. I promise it's going to be huge. But first, I got to go to New York and do this, this new show, The Wendy Williams Experience. Dice back on TV. It's about time. Unbelievable.
Let me just explain something to you. I haven't been on TV in a bunch of years doing my stand-up.
Yeah.
You know, so this jacket that I'm getting, you know, it's a very important jacket.
It's got to pop out for Showtime. It's got to just pop out.
You don't have to be so in.
It's your size?
I can't even get my... Forget this one. Is there something wrong with that? It's not a cool jacket?
It's a walk-around town jacket.
Really?
Yeah, but it's not Dice.
It looks like you're looking like you're getting to a, like a NASCAR almost. Too much NASCAR.
Yeah. No, well, I hate that like one. Take it off. Boom. Immediately.
Not red. I need something cool and black. This is what I like. Because it's not like fancy.
Okay.
But should have a great shape to it. Wheels, what do you think? You're the one that knows more about this stuff.
I mean...
You're the big designer.
I'm thinking... Designer? You know,
you're a designer?
Well, cakes.
Nice. This is Dice. This is who I am.
It's very dicey.
You know who I am, Ned?
Yeah, I know.
I'm the one telling you how it is.
One in the war.
I'm the one in the leather. I wear the leather. You don't keep Dice in a bag.
See how it just turned into that?
You know what I mean? You see what happens to me? This reads Dice. This reads, not this.
This,
wipe your ass with this. Let some farmer from the Midwest, from Nebraska.
Do that. Why do you do that?
I'm playing around.
Andrew, I'm telling you, I just don't want you to blow a chance. This is a big chance here.
Once
you put this jacket on, you become an animal.
People tell me all the time, oh, Dice, you got a hard time with anger. You should have, I should go to anger management. Today, you throw a chick down 3-4 flights of steps. People look at you like you're a f***ing animal. See how quiet the women get on that one? Oh, let me tell you something, girls. If I did a third of what I'm going to talk about up here, I'd be doing 25 to life in a maximum security prison, all right? Relax. In New York, gotta do this new Wendy Williams show. She's trying to dub herself as like, you know, the female Howard Stern. Let's see how you do with me first. Is this the green room? Because it's pink. It's nice, but it's pink. Let's see how I look, which I already know. Great. What's happening?
So why do you keep the cigarette? Just it's a nervous twitch?
You look like a soprano.
You look pretty good. I didn't know what to expect when I heard you were coming in here. But the thing is that you are still a highly recognizable person.
Yeah.
I mean, the hair has faded a bit. Have you ever thought about getting anything?
You know what? That's nothing. You know, you get a little thicker, you lose a little hair.
Yeah.
You know, as long as my talent don't go away.
Are you still married?
No, not as far as I know. We've been apart for over 4 years.
Do you still get groupies? You still get that even though you're not the celebrity you once was?
I never had to be a celebrity to get chicks. Look at me. No, serious. You want somebody to throw all your bullshit? You know what I mean?
Easy, Dice.
Wow.
We're not on satellite radio. This is a terrestrial radio.
Do you know what? I'm sorry.
This is the Wendy Williams Experience radio show. All right. So now you're getting your career back on track. Well, where have you been for the past...
You know, I have played, you know, a couple hundred arena shows. Mm. I haven't done them in a few years. And what I'm going to do, really trying to accomplish something that I haven't done.
Trying to make a comeback?
Well, that's...
Are you part of the show?
I'm a sidekick.
That's what you should be. A sidekick. Yeah. Funky.
He looks like a fat Fonzie.
You got a problem? I think he's angry that he's a zero that never got anywhere. By the time I was 26, I made $30 million. What'd you do? Carry a bag? You're a nobody that's never going anywhere that I never met. So we should really end this conversation.
Well, that means I won't be trying to
You'll never have to make a comeback because you're never going
Jesus
nowhere.
Jesus will be back before your career gets on track.
You got to put more into it when you say it. If you're going to be the heckler on the show, you have to know how to heckle.
Can you please throw
Hickory
it at us?
Hickory dickory dock, your sidekick was my
The clock struck two, I dropped my
jerk off block.
Man. Oh, look at Goose you know over I mean? There doing that's, the worst edits thing. I've ever heard in the you history I mean? Of radio.
I got no more dumps.
Oh, he's a jerk. Wow. All right, look, we're going to take a break.
All right.
Everybody, wow.
Hello. Yeah. Max. What a day. You know what? I feel bad. I did that Wendy Williams thing.
Yeah.
It was crazy. People were going crazy from it. Let me tell you something, Max. I shredded this guy.
I'm glad you mangled this guy.
It was intense. I actually got a headache from it. She started in a little with, you know, my hair, you know, the hair thing. In the meantime, it looked like she was wearing a poodle on her head.
I'm leaving for this Showtime gig tomorrow, and I got a million things to do.
Wheels, I gotta run all over today.
But I never ask you for anything.
Sometimes a man needs a friend, you know?
The Showtime thing, I think it'll be the perfect platform, rather than doing, you know, let's say a one-hour special right away to be... You know, part of a show like I did on the Rodney special years ago.
Little Boy Blue. He needed the money.
To bring Dice back into the public eye, you know, and, you know, I got plenty of material. You know, I've been going on stage. I feel loose. I got, you know, the perfect outfit. Wheels, what are you doing?
Well, you know, Ronnie's in town, right?
Let me fill you in on downtown Ronnie. We go back about 25, 30 years. He was good friends with my parents, you know, back in the neighborhood. But as far as I can remember, with Wheels and Ronnie, there's always friction.
Please, do me a favor. Don't call me on this beeper no more. I'm going to shoot the beeper.
You should understand.
I don't understand. I got a hard time on this.
Get your beeper and take your beeper and throw it away. What can I
throw it away?
Back in the day, Ronnie helped Wheels get back on his feet when he needed it, but he never got anything in return for it.
You don't go to school, you wind up a mule. Remember what I tell you.
So here we are, years later, and now that Wheels is doing good with his catering company, the Cannoli Kings, Ronnie's looking for a little payback. I told you 1,000 times to end that. What is wrong with you?
No, it's like he's asking me right now, and I'm in a predicament. I'm not in a situation.
Wheels, this is from 20 years ago, and this is still going on?
Maybe you could talk to me and help me out a little bit?
Wheels, I got to run all over today.
But I never ask you for anything. All I'm asking you to do is just talk to him.
I'm leaving town, and you should be getting ready to leave town.
No, I understand.
The is this? What is the problem? What's the problem? I'm not allowed to have a conversation?
So you're going to talk to
him? Rude L.A. person.
So you'll talk to him.
I'll talk to him. Believe me, I know how to talk to him.
I'll set it up.
All right. Yeah, you too. I get it. So anyway, I got to go up and meet with Lionel. What a treat. No day is fun, but I got to meet with the bloodsucker.
Lonnie, the funny man's here.
Everybody up here is just so friendly.
There he is now.
Andrew, you're an hour late.
I know.
All right,
I got kids that I can't just leave.
What's this with the glass? What are you, born in a barn? Use a coaster, for God's sakes.
You know, you don't know what goes on in somebody's life, you know, when they get up. You know, you shouldn't just attack
Andrew,
when I walk
we
in.
We both
here.
Got problems. We both have things to do. Let's just focus on getting your case over. There's one more thing that came up. It's about ownership of two dogs.
What do you mean, ownership of two dogs?
Your wife wants to be declared the owner of two dogs.
You're kidding me, right?
No.
Is this down on paper? Let me
see. It's right here. It's in black and white. See. Take a look.
Let me see. I see this. Golden Retriever and a Chihuahua. Number one, I got the Golden Retriever when Max was very young. I love that dog. You know, the Chihuahua, I don't know, really.
Yes or no?
Does it mean I don't see the dog if I give ownership of the dog? I never see the dog.
So you want me to come back to her and say she can have the dogs as long as you get visitation. Is that the deal?
Does the dog have a say? I mean, this costs money every time I come up here.
Andrew.
And I don't have the money to just keep spending on bull things like a dog. You know what? All right, she could own the dog.
Fine.
You know what I mean? There's not enough going on in life.
Is this over?
I don't have enough things going on in my
Andrew,
life.
Is this part over?
You know what? I can't even deal with this. You don't even know how I've been feeling lately. You know, with taking care of the children, and now I'm, like, thinking of, like, moving to the Valley. I mean, like, what do you think?
The plaque on the wall says Juris Doctor. It doesn't say psychiatrist.
It was my mistake to treat you as a human being, okay? Sometimes a man needs a friend, you know? I gotta go.
Okay. All right, Andrew. Always a pleasure. Andrew, could you put a coaster
right,
on?
Leave me alone with the coaster, okay?
Jesus. Take care, Andrew.
Yeah, okay. All right, goodbye. It's once you've walked that aisle a couple times, you know the game. You know it's pure loathing and hatred and distrust. That's marriage. It's a game. Why do you think I have no leather? The wife owns it now.
Hello? One second.
Wheels, I got a camera in one hand and a phone in another. My knee is driving the car.
You talking downtown, Ronnie?
I'm going to meet with him now.
No, but he just called me. He said he's waiting there. He's like, you know, I'm waiting.
All right, well, call him and tell him I'll be right there. I can't even touch the car, Wheels.
Right. Hey, Andrew.
Sorry, I'm late.
What do you want? You just want the loan money from...
Well, if I bought him a car when he had nothing and took a risk that I may never get it...
I can't even believe him because I told him. I said, just pay him the money. Just pay him and forget it.
Well, let him give me a car back at least.
See, that's what we can't have.
Why not take a piece of the cannoli? A small piece of the cannoli, King.
What am I going to do with pastry? Andrew, what do I need cannolis for? I've been eating them all my life. It's very simple.
Ronnie, why? You know what I mean? I can't keep hearing about a car.
That's all there is to it. It's Ronnie.
I'm supposed to leave tomorrow to do this Showtime thing, and I'm dealing with...
Just lease a cheap car, a Mustang, something. Not a big deal. What am I asking for? Rolls Royce Phantom?
If I get him to agree to a Mustang.
Tell him to go down there.
Don't tell him you want something
else.
No,
I'm not Wheels. If I say something, I live and die by it.
You know I'm happy to see you. You know that, right?
Come on.
Hey. What's up, Andrew?
What are you doing?
You got to really, you know, grease it up so it don't stain.
And you're going to go with the black, right? You know what I mean? Because, you know, I haven't done stand-up on television, I don't know, since around 96 or 97. That was, yeah, it's a long time. This has been the best part of my day so far. It's been complete stress. So I hope I look a lot better than I look right now with what you're doing. What are you putting in my hair? Gasoline? My eyes are burning. You didn't get the corner or the sideburns.
No, I'm getting them now.
Let me ask you something. Can I ask you something? I mean, it normally doesn't even bother me.
Right.
But you see, like, the front of my hair where it, you know, I've talked to you a little about where it's thinner. You know what I mean?
Dude, I had it done 2 years ago.
No, that's why I didn't want to say it because I didn't know if you would talk about it.
Do you even remember? I mean, it looked like John Lithgow.
It really looks great.
Yeah, I mean, look. I mean,
and how do they do it?
They
get the hair from back here.
Where, from the back of my head?
They cut it and they dice it and slice it and they jam it in there.
Frida, come here, man. Do you think it would be, like, I'm just talking to him, like, about maybe, like, doing, like, the front of my head, like, putting, like, hair there?
Yeah, you should.
This looks good, right?
Yeah, it looks great.
Let me just ask you, this isn't, like, this is something guys do, right? This isn't, like...
Yeah. It's what guys have to do.
You know, if I fail on that Showtime thing, I'll wind up 70 years old in comedy clubs where people pay a few bucks to see what used to be a legendary comic.
I need to talk to you. We got a problem.
I gotta go home. I gotta finish packing. Tonight I'll go to the comedy store. I'll do a set. You know, just to stay loose, just to keep everything moving. Look at the dice blades. Very cool. They sound great.
Really?
Yeah. I'm getting ready. I gotta leave for New York tomorrow morning to shoot this Showtime thing. Which is very exciting. I'm very psyched. So I'm bringing out the heavy-duty artillery. Look at this wristband. Look at that. That's going to look very cool. I feel like laying down. I don't feel like doing a set now. No, really. I could feel everything. Like, it didn't go, you know.
Be fine. Have a good set.
I'll see you in a little while. All right, buddy boy.
I'll be here.
What are you doing?
Everything all right?
Yes, I'm asking you, is everything all right? I tried to call 10 times. You don't pick up a phone.
My cell phone doesn't have reception everywhere. It just depends where I am.
Well, get a new phone already.
How many phones do I have to have?
You should get a new phone. You got to get a good phone, Todd. This is ridiculous.
Listen, it's all whenever taken care of.
It's not taken care of. Nothing's taken care of.
Everything's taken care of.
I talk to the hotels. I'll make sure everything's lined up. All the limos are lined up.
I'll take care of it.
Find Frazier, see when I could go out. Because I want to get up there.
Did you talk to him?
Wheels, I got to go on. I got to go on.
You spoke to him.
Did I say I was going to talk to him? Then I spoke to him, all right? You're going to have to get him a car. A Mustang. It's not even a big deal.
A Mustang?
Yeah.
I got to get him a car?
Yeah.
2 minutes, you're on 2 minutes.
We'll talk about it later. Let me go on.
You got to get him a car?
Andrew Dice Clay.
You thought you're walking into this world-famous place? And there's nobody here. That's pressure. You gotta make up for an entire front row. I mean, I'm up here every night. It's a sweat box. If I fail on that Showtime thing, the only one that fails is me. And I'll wind up 70 years old in comedy clubs where people come and pay a few bucks to see what used to be a legendary comic. I can't let that happen. Okay? Not just for me, but for my kids. That's all I'm doing. You've been a great crowd. Enjoy the rest of the show. Good night.
I caught a little bit of the set. That was good.
Really?
Yeah, it has a good new sound.
Oh, man. I'm not even trying. I'm gonna destroy. I'm just gonna f***ing kill. One of those. Those are the kind of sets I like you to see.
Yeah, you know, I heard some new stuff that I hadn't heard before. It sounded really good.
Just let the meter maid thing start working on that.
Meter maid was cute.
Don't let me forget that.
Yeah, that was good.
So I'm psyched. I can't wait to get out of here.
Listen, but I need to talk to you. We got a problem.
What's the problem?
Showtime is not going to happen. It's falling through. I think over the weekend when we were trying to negotiate and get all the terms worked out.
Yeah, I mean, just yesterday you told me that.
But I think what they did was they went and they hired another person over the weekend while we were working it all out. And they just kept us going until they locked the other person down.
They got a backup comic?
Yeah. Really tried to save it, but it's not savable. I think we've got better things to come our way. I really do.
It's just, there's no end to it. I mean, when we finally get there, it's really going to be a celebration because, I mean, just every step of the way is like walking on hot coals. I'm not going to sugarcoat this. We're not doing the Showtime thing. That's it. There was a time I used to be on the cover of every magazine. You know why. I'm gorgeous. But you know the truth is, it's been a while. Now there's this magazine. They want to do a whole thing with me. Complex magazine. They put people on the cover like Vince Vaughn, Gwen Stefani, Ashton Kutcher, those kind of people. They want to like try to update my look. My question is, how do you update perfection? Eh? Unbelievable.
Just got done looking at myself in the mirror. This is all you're gonna see of me. This is it. So I'm too fat. Tell you I'm a little unhappy about my weight. I'll get it together. I'll get focused. That every night it won't be a batch of ice cream and friggin' potato sticks. I went through this consultation. You see where my hair's a little thin up here and stuff? I'm told that they could, you know, like, fill that in. The thing is, when I get on stage, I like to feel a certain way. I like to look a certain way. The executives coming in to see you want to see the dice that they dug, you know, for all these years. They don't want to see a guy that looks completely different, completely let himself go. I mean, would you want to see a fat Mick Jagger?
Go ahead, Ben. How's it going?
Good, thanks. If I can have you sign in for me.
Yeah, it's for Dr. Zirchman.
Ziering.
Yeah.
Fill out the top part.
Show me which one of these guys you feel you can identify with.
I don't know. I'm just going to draw a little, like, what I'm looking for. Yeah, like, you should put, like, a pump.
Honey.
All right, like, you know, like that. I'll have him do it.
I don't think he can give you a pump.
Go ahead and come on back.
Oh.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Only permanent solution to hair loss is the transplant. We take the hair from the back of your head. This is what it looks like afterwards, and the hair just combs right back over top of it.
Do you do famous people?
Absolutely.
People in movies that I would see?
Yeah, absolutely.
With a lot of hair?
Absolutely.
Like who?
I can't tell you specific names.
It's a doctor.
But, you know, I mean, it's the confidentiality.
All right, any of them work with Julia Roberts?
I wouldn't reveal that.
Charlize Theron, any of them work with her?
I've done major movie stars who have probably worked with most other major movie stars.
Toni Collette. See how it's like thinning over here? It's been like that for a long time, and I really didn't care, but now that I'm starting to do bigger shows again.
Sure.
Look, hold the other one up, Wheels. All right. Now, you see this? I want to look more like him. This is what it used to be.
We want to move you from this to this. I'm going to draw on you, and I'll show you what I'm talking about.
Now, I'm a touch freak. I don't like people to really touch me.
What you want to do is kind of frame out roughly where the hairline would be. Uh-huh. On the back of your head, I'm going to draw this as well.
How long does it take to grow in?
After 10 days, the little tiny scabs will fall off and you won't be able to see them.
You don't know. Look how good I'm going to look, babe. You know, I got to look a certain way in this business. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
I'm not like the regular clown comic. You know, I'm known as a pretty good looking guy. I'm not like a goofy type of clown. You know what I mean? I'm like a good looking guy.
Right.
Come off this pencil.
It's a whole thing. They take it from here, they put it there.
I think a few less hairs shows a little character in a person.
My hair out? Because I got a lot of it. If he could use.
I don't want to take your hair. They don't use your hair.
Why not?
What am I going to have, blonde in the front?
No, you could, like, dye it.
I'm not taking a baby's hair and putting it in the front of my hair. Besides, you know what? We got too much to do right now. It's just, there's the friggin' traffic always. We haven't gone boxing in a long time. I'm going to teach you guys who the boss is here. I'm the trainer when we're here. This isn't Daddy. This is the trainer. Okay? Never gets easy. Cross your arms, that's it.
No pain, Locke.
Did you brush your teeth?
Go for it.
I'm gonna beat him like a piece of meat.
I ain't the one breathing heavy.
Don't hit below.
I don't hit below the belt.
You better keep your form.
He's 12 years old. I know what you're doing.
Hey, just think of...
He's 12. Go give him advice. Okay. I don't need the advice. I know what I'm doing.
What?
What? That was low already. No? That's too low. Keep your form. Keep your hands up. Punk! Punk! Good fight. Good workout. Like a lot of these girls today, they work out too much. They get too skinny. Now the big thing is spinning. They spin like little hamsters on a wheel. Me, you gotta see my chick. Wide, broad, thick and beefy, 2 feet deep from belly to back, with a triple chin on the back of her head. My ex, and I'm glad to say my ex, she went and moved to the other side of the hill. Now, I don't live on the other side of the hill. I've been living here, you know, in Hollywood for, I don't know, 26 years. I put a deposit on a house. I found a house. I just said, it. It's not worth the aggravation. I'd rather have my sons be together. Okay? So here, see, I got boxes. I got lots of boxes.
Andrew, please stop with the worrying. I can't stand it.
I wound up signing for the new house, and everybody here is now packing. I told the boys to start putting, you know, getting rid of things they don't want. You know, we got to clear out. I need their help. I asked for regular boxes, not for this.
This is a regular box? What's a box?
Why is all this fighting going on?
She's not fighting, I'm just, he's whining.
I'm not whining.
You're like Humpty Dumpty every day. Fall off the wall, we gotta pick you up and put you back together.
I feel like I'm 107 and a half. And you're laughing.
I'm not laughing. I have, just pretend like you're doing something vile and you'll feel better.
There's just so much. I don't know how we're gonna do it. Dylan, you wanna see something? Look at that. Look at that. That's one of the Vegas belts. Look at this.
It looks 70.
Put your hands, Red Fox.
That's Telly Savalas. Kojak.
Wow. And Roseanne.
Yeah, that's Roseanne.
Really?
There's a picture of me.
Clay Silver's on the drums. That's before I even started doing stand-up comedy. Look at this. This is the garden.
That's the garden?
I haven't looked at this in years. This is over 9,000 studs. Wow.
Look at that.
I wore this Radio City.
That was
I don't like it.
That's awesome.
That really looks good on me, though.
That's good. Yeah. Don't come past the halfway mark.
I like it that way.
Give it a little lower than the halfway mark. Who knows how to wear a leather better than me?
Nobody.
These are great.
Jack and Jill went up the hill.
All right, don't, please.
Your mother's going to watch the show. Humble went to get her old dog a bone.
She bent over. Oh, she got a bone of her own.
Damn, I can't believe you.
What happened to Rover took over?
I don't know.
All right, you got to practice. You got to practice more.
Rovers are here.
Do you work out?
His arms are like watermelon.
It's all show.
Try to find some fabric for drapes for the new place.
It's a masculine bedroom. It's my bedroom. Fine, let it be your bedroom. Just pick the thing. Let's just do it.
Eleanor, please. I gotta get my beauty sleep, Eleanor. I gotta do the photo shoot.
That'll wake you up.
Eleanor, what are you doing?
Honey, please.
No, sir. Who's that?
Oh, the movers are here.
They're coughing.
Honey, he's sleeping.
Okay, you got like we're scared if they were moving for me?
Yeah. Huh? They have to take a look. He's asleep, I'm sorry. The end table's right.
George, what's going on?
How you doing?
What do you work out? Come here just for 1 second. Mr. President, it's like a rocket.
What's doing? That?
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. I woke up with it.
Like that?
Yeah, just a little.
You do
that. I don't know. He knows what he's doing.
They have to work. They don't need to
he's
massage you.
He's stronger than you.
What's wrong with you? Oh, I'm so sorry.
What are they doing with all that noise? Is there a way to calm the noise? Please make coffee. I don't even know where I am.
Oh, Eleanor and me engagement picture. It's not me. I'm not in any of these.
Very nice, kid. Look at that picture. There you are.
Andrew.
Lee? I'm glad you're here. Could use your help.
I don't know if I ever mentioned. I mean, honestly, I have a herniated disc. Now, you know I've moved. You know how many times I've moved?
Uh-huh.
You're not movers, the kings of transfer.
They're very good.
And you know I would carry if you needed it. I just don't want to be in the hospital.
No, I just want you, you know, helping supervise and everything.
Absolutely. To oversee, fine. The actual work, though, I can't.
Eleanor. Yes, sir. This is my girlfriend, Eleanor, fellas. We've been together 4 years now.
This wasn't
just a one-night thing.
Said that.
No, I'm saying it could have been. Let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
Who knows the most about criminal activity?
Andrew.
No, because you see that little lock? I can't find the key. Look at me. I need somebody to open it. You got a pick or something? You know how to do it.
Oh, my God, Andrew.
Me. I need to open that because I don't have the key.
I try it.
How about we try it now, huh? Roll your muscles. You can't open a little lock.
Honey, please.
It's like, it's stupid. We're just trying to talk
Stop
to a man.
Stop calling me stupid.
I don't really believe you're stupid in that sense.
You got it. Very sweet. Thank you.
See, you're unbelievable. God bless
you. Jesus Christ.
They
make it.
Be careful. Take your time. There you go. Yeah, you got that.
Oh, yeah.
He's all show.
What? His arms are like watermelons.
Yeah, he's all show. Look at this. Nothing.
I know.
Nothing. See, I can carry this like on my nose. Yeah, what do you think? I never carried that chair down the steps? I wanted to laugh with all his muscles. You give a guy like that one smack. All of a sudden, he ain't such a tough guy. How do I look in this outfit? It's pretty cool.
You look really cute. You look like a giant third grader.
Hey, Z.
You're an idiot.
Unbelievable.
That's bad thinking. Live together. You really want to get to know me that well? Now you're in 900 square feet with the same animal every day. How many times a day can you pass the same person and go, hey, how you doing? What's boy, I just saw you. That was me. Did you hear me taking a piss?
All right, I gotta go to this fabric store. Try to find some fabric for drapes for the new place. What are you doing?
You're late.
I'm sorry. What am I supposed to do?
This is what he was showing me while we were waiting.
This blends exactly perfect with that.
I know.
Wait,
I like this.
Can I say one thing without chopping my head off? Yeah. This, I just was at the house and the walls are painted.
No, one wall is this color now in the bedroom.
But I have a feeling that'll clash with it.
No, but it's got a very warm feeling. And
no, it definitely does. That's what I'm saying.
What I mean?
But you might be better off with.
This was the one you liked last time.
I like that one.
You know, that's also very nice.
This goes with your carpet.
sea foam.
It's very pretty.
Oh, maybe, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I think this is a little too much.
It's not too much, Eleanor. I don't know why you keep saying it's too much.
Okay, if you like it, then get it, but I'm just saying.
What do you think of this?
I like that, too.
I'm not looking to, you know, just make my whole bedroom cream. But what do you think of this?
I like it.
What do you like about it? This is like
this was the main contender.
I mean, it's a, you know, it's my bedroom. It's a masculine room.
Let's just make a decision, please.
No, I can't do it that way. I can't, you know, I don't want to be in a bad
mood.
We've
been here for an hour. Just pick.
What is wrong with you?
Well, every time he shows you one, you're like, oh, it's too feminine. It's a masculine bedroom. It's my bedroom. Fine, let it be your bedroom. Just pick the thing. Let's just do it.
Don't you know this is for us? You know, I just, you know, I kid around with these guys, you know? I won't do it again.
Sorry.
You know, who cares about anybody, right? You gotta take care of your baby. Come on. You know, I'm in a relationship that, you know, just keeps exploding.
Oh, you have moods, Andrew. Look at the mood you have. You're like Moody Blues.
Our fashion director is going to give you a little bit more contemporary look.
What am I putting on?
Cream.
This is like a more metrosexual.
No, you wear it.
Isn't that good? It's fabric. It's fabric.
Well, that's in your mind, it's fabric. In her mind, it could be something else, Andrew.
I always tell her, like, you know, she gets moody, you know, and she'll even admit it to me. She goes, I know I have my moods.
Well, you have moods, Andrew. Look at the moods you have. You're like Moody Blues.
This is my new house. I'm entitled to pick out what I want on my windows.
Could it be even deeper than the drapes or the curtains or any of that? Could it be something a little deeper? I'm just asking you, open your mind.
You know, I'm in a relationship that, you know, just keeps exploding, you know, every other minute. And I don't know why.
But you can't let it interfere. This is probably the most important photo shoot of your life. Please, I'm just saying, be the Andrew that you are.
You the photographer?
Yes.
How's it going?
Jared Ryder.
What's your name?
Jared Ryder.
Jared, how you doing?
Always in gloves.
I'll tell you why. A lot of people, when they shake your hand, they don't wash their hands.
Yes.
They blow their nose in their hands. They're filthy animals, a lot of people. I don't need to get the Hong Kong flu because some guy decided to blow his nose in his hands and then look at it like it's a Picasso painting.
Our fashion director, Noma, here is going to hook you up with some new clothes.
All right, that's okay.
Make you over, give you, you know, a little bit more contemporary look.
We're going to be doing basically a thug eye for a white guy, and we're going to take your style and show you how to wear it as a thug. Do the fronts.
The what?
We're gonna do the teeth. You got some teeth. Gold fronts. Huh? Oh my gosh.
He's like that guy. I'm changing. What am I putting on? Gray's cool. I'm not into that. Cream? No. Hey, look at this purple t-shirt.
This is the complex look. Best thug, more style.
Like, are you feeling the colors, like the purple and the pastel? Is that too soft for you?
I don't like it.
But you know there's like more metrosexual looks, so that's why it's like they're using the pastel.
You wear it. You know, I'd never wear this t-shirt in 1,000 years in the sweatshirt I give to my girlfriend. You know what I mean? You want to play metrosexual? You want to walk around going, you know, I want to him or her? That's your problem. Me, I like just
do you want to wear your leather? I mean, I thought your leather jacket was a real signature you look.
Oh, yeah, it is. I want to rock! We'll start with this.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
That's what I remember right there.
That's it. You get in the back of that? I might be a little older and a little thicker, but I know what's right for me, okay? Dice is dice. Now, this is just the new school dice you haven't seen.
I say, just remember, the only place success comes before work is in the dictionary.
Mm-hmm.
Over 17 years old.
Wait, say that again. Hello?
Hello, my name is Steve. I'm calling on behalf of the Centers for Disease Control.
Yeah, so what do you want from me? Everybody's okay.
I was just calling to see if you had any...
Calling to see what? Because you didn't go to school and study, so there's not a good job for you to get in this world because you didn't want to listen to your parents? Face. Go back to school, learn something, and then go out in the world and learn a trade so you can make an honest dollar for yourself.
I have a degree. Sir.
You got a degree? You got a degree up your ass. That's what I think.
Why are you so angry, sir?
I'm not angry. This is not mad, okay? This is mad! When I'm like this, I'm not mad. You understand?
Sir, it's your blood pressure.
It's not my blood pressure. My blood pressure is perfect. 120 over 80. Every time, all day long.
I love with these telepeople.
Yeah, I actually made albums when they were real albums, when albums were actually vinyl. Look at this. Dice, known as the Black Album. Went gold in 2 weeks, okay? Now you got this. Data Laughter Dice went gold in a week. Face down, ass up, just because I like the position, okay? So what I'm going to do, I'm actually going to head to Houston to a smaller club, a club where the sound is really great, and I'm going to record a new album on this thing called the CD. But first, I got to meet with this record executive to see if he wants to do the album with me.
Rich Holtzman, Andrew Dice Clay. So Rich is from a label called Reincarnate.
I've been working on what I call coming out of retirement. And now it's time to record an album, so.
You said you were in retirement.
Yeah, we're coming out of retirement.
With all due respect, nobody knows you were in retirement. You have a lot of work to change everybody's mind so that you actually mean something and that you're still funny. First of all, if you're going to do comedy albums, think about how you're going to make the comedy album. Just to go in and record a comedy album like you used to do it in the past is not the way to do it. You need something more akin to what you are. You know, you're the rock and roll comic.
Mm-hmm. Would you have any suggestions, like, because, you know, like producing-wise, I really need the sound.
There's people out there who can record it, will give you that rock and roll feel. There's this guy, who are we talking about?
Mike Bradford. Do you think Bradford he would be good?
Well, he's worked, you told me with him.
Right.
Some of the people he's worked.
Cracker, yeah, it comes out of Kid Rock.
Yeah, if there's a rock and roll element.
Okay. So why would you want to do a Dice album?
I can do it. I want to do it because I can make money on it.
Here we go. I like him already. You know what I like? The honesty.
Remember Sex in the City? Remember that? I couldn't for 5 years because of that show. The ugliest woman in the history of television. What are you talking about? Sarah J. Whatever her name was, had a face that looked like it did prison time. As far as that show went, she so many guys, her must look like Rocky's eye. If her could talk, it would sound like this. Hey, yo, Mick. I'm gonna make this guy Mick.
I've been trying to go easy on my voice when I'm not on stage. Drinking a lot of tea don't help. I even went to see a guy about my ears. That don't help. You know, on stage I could get loud sometimes.
No!
You got a bad attitude, lady! Oh!
So I'm gonna go get some help. I need to see somebody to... It's a muscle like anything. Like a bicep, like a... You know? It's a muscle. I'm glad you were able to see me today. You know, I'm performing for a long time. I've done huge concerts, but I went on stage this Monday night, a small room, and by the time I came off, 40 minutes in, it's like, I'm scared to sneeze. It hurts. Should I sit?
No, if you would stand back over there. Okay. You know, Andrew, that we're going to be singing, though, right?
No, I didn't know that.
I want you to be up higher.
I'm doing it. I'm very serious. I'm saying
All right, I don't understand.
You know, the reason you don't understand is because it takes time. Have you seen my list of clients by any chance?
No, I haven't.
Oh, you would not believe who's stood in this room and done this.
Really?
Yeah.
Who?
Britney Spears, Gwen Stefani, Linkin Park.
Hey! I'm a Britney fan.
I'm a big Britney fan. So, the thing about the breathing is, you need to do is get the air down here. Here's another thing I want to show you. Yeah. So we're going to try this. No, your fingers are too high. Look at me.
How long?
Well, I want you to try and sing with it. Ya, ya, ya,
okay. Ya, 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 ya,
ya, ya.
That's a Brooklyn thing, because you're looking around to know your surroundings.
Right. Do you feel how hard that is for you to do?
Uh-huh.
Right.
These are great exercises.
I'm glad you like them. You're done.
I'm done? You know what? I didn't know what to expect, because I never did a voice lesson, you know, and I don't know if it's, you know, that you're that good at what you do, or is it just, you know what I mean? You're very good.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
We're late to see this record producer.
Look at this traffic. Look at this.
So she really teaches singers?
No, she teaches you through singing. Listen.
Is that the, one of the exercises?
Yeah, it's all in breathing, like... do it with me, I'm telling you.
Big time Mikey, I already gave you a nickname.
Is that so? Good to meet you, man.
This place used to be three houses, so this was once a little house. That's the studio.
What I'm trying to create is the same grittiness of what I did even back then. You know, because the one thing I don't want the fans to think is, like, that I've changed my style of performing.
Right.
I want you to listen just a little of the first album.
All right.
Here, I'll just give that to
cool.
You. I'm telling you, that's why masturbation is king. Oh, yeah, you know it, I know it, so who we bullshitting, huh? I shit everything in the house when I was a kid. Didn't make no difference to me. Socks, gloves. My mother's got a mink coat that doesn't need a hanger anymore. You see what I'm saying to you?
That timing is like a musician, though. That's musical stuff.
You know, Dice to me is, you know, it's more of a rock star than a comic.
Right.
Anyway, I think it would just be great. I mean, we seem to, you know, vibe really good together.
Yeah.
I'm doing this. Like in a week.
Right.
Next weekend in Houston. How long does it normally take you to set up all the equipment?
You know, in a perfect world, maybe 4 to 6 hours. The more time, the better.
Let's do it. This was great. This was a great hang. Which way are we going?
A little to the left, this way.
Tonight we start recording the album. I'm very excited.
I just wanted to make sure that Big Time Mikey's here.
Where are you?
This is unbelievable. My sound guy should have been here, I don't know, 6 hours ago. I don't give a do it. Do it! You know, I gotta come here more often, Wheels.
Yeah, it's just been a crazy, you know, week for me.
What are you cooking here?
I got some water here, so when I cut the onions, I don't cry. You know, you have to add flour and butter to that and a bunch of other stuff.
Wheels, I'm a comedian. This isn't my thing.
Wheels, what's this? Is this
that's the au jus. That goes
is this
to the
a demi-glace?
That's an au jus.
Au jus.
Todd, put it down.
What's an au jus?
You dip the prime rib.
It's gravy. Leave it alone. That's going to somebody.
I'm starving, man. We got to get something to eat.
What are you touching?
That's a display for a wedding.
Huh?
That's going to be a display. Well, it was going to be a display.
Don't put it back. That's somebody's.
Do you have a toothpick or something?
That belongs to somebody. You definitely can't go this weekend?
I can't go. I can't make it Friday and Saturday.
So it's just going to be me and you then?
I can't go.
Wheels, I was counting on you. I thought you were going with me.
I got cannoli king parties booked everywhere. It's impossible. Look what I got here. I mean, this is crazy already. Even now, I'm overwhelmed.
Just do it myself?
Yeah, do it yourself, and? I'm sure it'll be fine.
I'm waiting for Big Time Mikey. We're here in Houston. Tonight we start recording the album. I'm very excited. He was actually supposed to be in a little earlier than me, so I don't know what's going on here. I'm waiting for a friend of mine to get in from L.A., but I don't know the number.
Should have gone in at 247. It's now 505.
505?
Yeah.
What, are you kidding me? I normally have a road manager.
Where the is the baggage claim?
Who's baggage?
2 floors down.
I normally have a road manager. I know I should know better, but for years it's been like this. It's like you gotta be led by the hand because I'm supposed to be thinking about my shows.
I don't even know what flight I was on.
Luggage is in the car.
You're the driver?
Yes, sir.
The bag's in the car?
Yes, sir.
Now, this isn't gonna be a 30-minute walk, is it? Because I'll give you a smack.
No, 5 minutes, sir. No problem.
All right, come in.
Thank you for coming back.
Yeah. How is it in there? Good?
Yeah, it's going to be phenomenal.
Yeah. How's it going? Good to see you. Who's this guy already? Do me a favor. Go get Pete again. I want to find out about the sound guy. Yeah, I want to know if he's here and set up.
It'll be all right.
Yeah, well, I just want to find out. I just want to make sure. I came here to record.
I know.
You know what I mean?
But the guy I work with, Kid Rock, Uncle Cracker.
You don't have to tell me his credits. I know who the guy is. I just want him here. Mikey, it's Dice. Where are you?
I finally got here, but here's the new thing. Bags. Nobody knows where they're gonna be.
Mikey, the show starts in less than 40 minutes. I know you may took off late, whatever.
You want to make God laugh? Tell me your plans.
I mean, we're gonna be able to make this. It's the reason I came here. All right. I'll see you in a little while. All right.
It's the Dice Man.
This man is the man. There's nobody in the world that can compete with this guy.
Glad to see you back, buddy.
He's not PC. I like that.
How's my throat sound? It's amazing, and I've done the biggest concerts, and now I'm screwing up. Got like a falsetto going on. What are the exercises?
A lot of them are like tongue twisters and stuff, like rubber baby buggy bumpers, rubber baby buggy bumpers, rubber baby buggy bumpers.
I didn't get that far with it. Rubber baby bumpy bumpers.
Rubber baby buggy bumpers.
Ruggy baby bumpy bumpers.
Rubber baby buggy bumpers.
I just said that.
Rubber baby buggy bumpers.
Rugger baby bumpy bumpers. Rubber baby bumpy bumpers. Rubber baby bumpy bumpers. Rubber baby bumpy
buggy bumpers.
Stop it! Why'd you hit me?
Well, because I can't believe you did it wrong. Because I want you to get it right.
Do you want me to punch you in the face? This is unbelievable. My sound guy, my technician, should have been here, I don't know, 6 hours ago, setting up, running lines through the room, testing the monitors on stage, making sure I could hear myself perfectly, making sure that there were just enough mics hanging from the ceiling to capture the sound of the crowd as well as it captures my sound. I just wanted to make sure that Big Time Mikey's here, the sound guy.
Your technician?
Yeah.
There was a guy that came in just now.
What do you mean just now? Go make sure that he's set up.
All right.
Please. I got to know that he'll be ready.
I hope you guys are having fun, too. I hope it's not all
good. This guy's got six more minutes. Are you ready for Dice?
Don't worry about it.
He's got a whole different board.
I thought he was going to come in and use ours.
Hey, do me a favor. Get him set up.
Look, he's on my ass, and I mean, really, I got a show to start. These people are here waiting.
Yeah. Got here late. A lot of problems. Keep him calm. Keep him cool upstairs. Tell him 5 minutes.
Tell Dice 5 minutes.
Did you take care of this guy?
Sir, yes. I talked to Mike. He said about 5 minutes. So, I mean, I'm going to go down there and
get him. How can it be 5 minutes? Normally, they get here hours in advance to set up the room.
I'll wait 5 minutes with him, and if there's something happen, I'll be back.
Okay.
So I'm
let's get it. Let's get it. Do it.
Mr. Harder.
I'm Mike Black. Thank you guys for having me.
I love you. You know that. I'm not looking to be aggravated with you. If the guy is not ready to record, I am not going on the stage.
Minutes, he's gonna have the audience mic and your mic set up. Boom, boom, boom.
He's gonna have it all set, right?
Yeah, perfect.
Okay.
And please don't forget to tip your waitresses, your waiters. You guys ready for your headliner tonight?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Brooklyn, New York. Out of retirement for you here tonight. The undisputed heavyweight comedy king.
Hey, what's your name?
Deborah.
You ever seen my show before? Oh, you have?
Oh, filthy animal you married, huh?
You ever hear this? Whip it out! Let me explain something. White guys, and I'm white too, we don't whip anything out. We'll take it out. We'll make a beautiful presentation, but there won't be any sound effect. It's not going to sound like a London broil hitting a kitchen counter. No, but it's the truth. Like, even if you look at the NBA, you know what I mean? Years ago, it was all the white players. The shorts were little short shorts up to here. Today, they're pins, basically. Because if it wasn't, it would be a pay-per-view event.
Mikey.
Hey, man, how you doing?
I heard about your day. I'm sorry.
Oh,
get over here.
I tell you what, I've done easier things.
Uh-huh.
But this one worked out pretty good in the end. That's all it really
did
counts.
It? You were all set by the time
by I the came? Time you came on, it was running. It was all recording. Mics all over the room. Got the whole show.
Really?
In surround.
I'm but gonna, let me, did I make you laugh tonight?
I was laughing my ass off.
They're in Texas now, my friends.
She's a little blonde. Maybe I'll have a couple laughs with her. Unbelievable.
September 1997. Good behavior doesn't come naturally to me. And if Howard Stern was in front of me at that moment, our argument would have become physical. Anyway, that's when our relationship started to get more combative. There was a lot of pressure on both of us. That's right. I'm writing a book. The Filthy Truth, writing it by hand, and I'm going to New York hopefully meeting with some publishers to see if they want to buy my story. I'm also going in to meet with Howard Stern, who I haven't talked to in 10 years. I'm going to go on his new Sirius radio show. Howard was one of the few people that I became friends with outside of the showbiz thing, and I always felt bad that our relationship crumbled. I'd like to make up with him, but you know what? I don't know what the f*** is going to happen.
Pack everything in?
You all packed?
Huh?
You pack everything?
Something wrong with you.
Did you pack yesterday?
When do you think I packed?
Well, the reason
last week, last month.
Well, the reason why I asked is because
I just woke up. It's six. What time is it? Six what?
6:30? 6:37?
I don't really mean what time it is. It's early in the morning, that's what I mean. Cozy? Oh. Anything else you need me to do?
Oh, no, you're good.
I hate people that aren't from where I'm from. That's who I am. If I'm walking around Brooklyn and I see a farmer, I want to grab the pipe out of my car. Not because I'm a violent person. That's it. That's the only reason. And I'm not necessarily going to beat them to death. It's not like they took my parking spot. You know, just hurt them a little. Just for saying, you're from Des Moines and you're in Brooklyn. Your ankle has to be broken now.
There she is. How are you there? Get over here.
Good to see you.
Thank
How
you.
Are you?
All right.
Come on back. Yeah. So this is what you gave me.
If we could do a 1,200-page book, is that good?
No, that is not good. Well, the good news is I sent it to 15 people. So far, we've had 4 passes, and 3 people want to take meetings.
Out of 15?
Yeah, we've got a lot of chances, and a lot of people are happy about it. But it's weird because I've had a big cross-section of responses.
I like hearing this stuff.
Okay. One of the things that people are really struck by is the anger, like how angry the book seems, how you lash out at, say, Jay Leno. I mean, you do sort of go off on a number of people. And I think that's great because it's new. Then one publisher called you barely literate.
What do you mean?
Well, you know, there was just so many misspellings and so many grammatical errors.
But I don't spell like normal people.
I know.
I spell the way I feel it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't go by the alphabet. I use the alphabet.
You don't go by the
But
alphabet.
If you say a word like feeling, put 3 G's at the end. Draw it out a little.
Mm-hmm.
If I spelled it out.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so who requested meetings?
A Random House imprint, a Penguin imprint, and an independent so far.
But now do it with the cardboard cover?
Hardcover, yes.
Yeah, because I don't like that soft, you know what I mean?
You don't like the paperback.
We do like a leather.
Yeah, we'll talk about that, but not
a leather cover on top of the cardboard.
Right.
I'll see what they got to say. Don't worry, I'll talk to them with that. You just get me in there and I'll do the rest.
And how much should I ask
And be
them
sincere.
For?
No, we're not going to talk about money in the meeting. Just let me deal with that.
That's what everybody taught. Don't bring up money. Nobody's paying me for anything.
Nobody wants to talk about money. When we go into these meetings tomorrow, what I need you to do is just be really amenable and humble and
amenable.
Nice. Amenable.
Yeah, what,
you know,
what
you just want to be open to suggestions.
I'm the nicest guy in the world, but what am I going to do?
Just say yes.
All right. There he is. Oh, how nice of you to come up at 2:30 in the afternoon. Look who finally showed up. Look at that. Look who finally showed up. Did you sleep good? Where is he? He doesn't call about anything. You know what he did? He slept and put a do not disturb on his phone. That's what he did. He takes care of nothing. This is unreal. You better stop hiding from me, because if... I see him. Todd, I'm telling you, it's not even funny. It's not even funny. You want to call yourself a road manager?
Yeah.
You want to call yourself a road manager?
No.
Yeah? What?
No,
you know what? No, you
don't.
You shouldn't.
No, I know.
You shouldn't.
No,
you shouldn't. And when I deduct it from your pay,
because
when your check reads a big zero, when his check reads a nice big zero. Yeah,
go ahead.
Shh. What? Unless you're going to tell me.
The crumbs you pay me, keep it, sweetheart.
With book agent? No, book. You're the agent.
Yeah, that's me.
Yeah, we're book meeting. Here we are. There's my attorney. This is an exciting day, and we're gonna sell our book. My book.
You guys ask me 1,000 questions. Give me some money and then talk.
What was that? This.
I won't think that in the book.
For any amount of money.
No, I didn't like that guy. Had a bad attitude. He's lucky I didn't give him a crack in his mouth.
You know what? I don't even want an offer from that guy. And tell him if I see him, he's going to have a real problem with me.
On our way to the Howard Stern Show.
10 years, if he wants to fight.
Now, that
this
was
is
show,
what I, no, but this
that
is what I was mad
should.
About.
He came to the right place.
Going up to see Danny Hayes. We're going to call Aaron, my book agent. See what's happening.
Aaron.
Yeah.
Hey, you got Danny and Dice.
Hey.
It was a pretty good day today, huh?
It was a good day.
When people act nice, I'm nice. And if people don't act nice, I'm not nice. What am I supposed to do?
Yeah, I know.
Kiss everybody's ass?
I talked to the people that we have the two best meetings with.
Okay.
Unfortunately, they have decided to pass.
Why?
The fear is that it's too risky about knowing whether your career is going to take off.
Whoever don't want us, I don't even care about.
Well, the other people have asked for a little more information.
Information?
They were just hoping for some footage of Andrew's latest stand-up.
Why do they need that for a book?
Yeah, well, this is a book.
I have a feeling that it's for the bosses, the people who write the checks.
I mean, do we need to talk about expectations of money?
What are your expectations, Andrew?
$1 million, not a penny less. I gave them an 800-page book.
I know, but they don't pay for the page. Take a minute to talk to Andrew about reality of a book advance.
That is pretty unrealistic.
Was there any other feedback from anybody else that we met with?
The consensus was really that the book that they're looking for is the book written by the Dice Man. The book now is written as Andrew.
Him. This is an autobiography. It's not being written by the stage act. I got kids that are going to read this book. What are they going to read? I got my this chick's ass. You know what? I don't even want an offer from that guy. And tell him if I see him, he's going to have a real problem with me. People, it's a waste of... Why'd they even call me to come up then?
Well, they like the manuscript.
You know,
him. This is why we're getting some rejection.
If you're truthful about who you are, they don't want to hear it. And then when you're not truthful, they go, well, who's the guy behind the leather? Who's the real person? And then when you tell them, they don't want to hear.
I will certainly be in touch.
Okay.
I'll
give you something to touch.
Aaron, you still there?
I'm going to be going on Howard Stern tomorrow morning.
Last thing I need is to get upset over some jerk-off book publisher that doesn't know his ass from his elbow. So you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go back to Brooklyn tonight, see some family, see some friends, people I really care about, and that care about me.
Good, baby.
What's happening to you?
How you doing? Now that I see you, great, baby.
Andrew! Oh, my brother.
Well, my
What's
brother.
Going? I'm glad we decided to meet here.
There's a little boy.
You know my sister?
Yeah, we met at the Borgata.
Did you ever meet my Aunt Carol?
His nickname is the little boy.
Yeah, because he's very young looking.
He's got a boy's face. Yeah,
when he gets introduced on stage, everybody's looking like, why is he called the little boy? He's 57 years old.
You're not 57.
I'm telling you something.
Look at this room.
How you doing?
How's everything?
Tommy.
How you doing?
You're not 57.
I can't believe this. You know what? We might actually have to move tables.
Need a bigger table?
Yeah. Push this one down.
Holy mackerel.
What are you doing? Grab that other little table. Let's see. Is this better? Look who I found at the counter now. All right, let's move the table back. Come on. What's going on?
How you doing, guys?
Two more squares and we're good?
We got to move that down.
Yeah, let me help you here.
Let's go.
What's going on?
Yeah,
the brush is there. What are you doing? I can't believe this.
What are you doing?
You want
I know it sounds crazy, but I almost look at myself almost like the Rocky Balboa stand-up. Yeah, I keep coming back. It's unfinished business. You know, like what happened with me. But I want to do Giant Stadium.
Listen to me. If anybody could do this, it's you.
This is the Brooklyn Bridge. This is Dice's Bridge. This is Dice's home. And just being in that diner tonight, it's like I never left it.
I agree.
You know what I mean? I feel like this is the moment.
It was great going back to Brooklyn and seeing everybody. It's just what I need before I go back on Stern.
I just got off the phone with Happy Face. He's very psyched about tomorrow morning, the Stern Show. I am too. I mean, I've had really no sleep at all. I'm gonna tire myself out so I can go to sleep, but I gotta walk in there completely prepared, and I will.
Now, you know how I felt about Dice's last appearance. I thought it was rather weak. And Dice is slamming me, saying, I'm not daring. God, Dice has lost it. Mm-hmm. His last movie sucked. His HBO special sucked. And I'm there trying to resuscitate the guy, and he's bad-mouthing me, blaming it on me, that I've lost it.
Hey, what's going on?
Nothing really.
I can't sleep. I'm pacing. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I feel like Rocky before he fought Apollo Creed the first time.
You gotta go in there like an animal. Don't go in mad, but like really tough, like you're prepared.
I'll have my guard up.
Just kill tomorrow.
I will. I'll do great, and you'll listen.
Do great. I'll talk to you tomorrow.
All right, bye. I don't know how he gets up this early. Game face. In the lobby at the hotel, there's Happy Face and Todd.
You ready?
Ready to go.
Yeah. On our way to the Howard Stern Show. That's right.
Legend. My brother, there ain't no other.
Get over here. Here we are, Rosé Band.
He's the first man to book me in New York.
Exactly.
Where we go?
Follow the camera, please.
Follow the camera, yeah.
Wow.
Come on.
All right, you getting my good side? Where am I going? Right this way?
I was reminded that he was calling me up and calling me Rat Boy. There should be some fireworks. I went back and researched and read why I got angry.
All right.
I saw this public attack on me, and I said, you know what? Screw this.
You know what?
You know, you're doing some bravado, and you said, hey, Stern is weak.
He's angry.
He's toned down. You were angry with about the appearance, and you were angry with me. Now, that
this
was
is
show,
what I, no, but this that is was what I was mad used, about.
Yes. But to publicly go and do that, I got a short fuse. I went nuts.
Yeah, but, you know, and you know how to push the buttons. Like, I know how to push buttons. He's not funny anymore.
Well,
he's
you
not
pushed the so, wrong one when you said he's done. He's washed up.
And you went off on me, and you know what? You got the louder mic.
Of course.
And you beat the out of me.
I felt my back was against the wall because now someone's challenging
my friend
Dice. I mean, there's maybe four people I ever speak to off the air.
And then we never spoke again. And years went by.
I don't think it is an easy thing for anyone to pick up the phone and say, hey, look, this is silly. I certainly missed you and I missed our friendship.
That's what it is.
I'm glad you did it.
Like when I buy a Valentine's Day card, now you got to write something special to them.
Right.
Like you're going to beat out a team of writers from Hallmark. What am I going to write? Number one, I can't find the card to my girlfriend that says what I feel unless it starts with, hey, face. You know what I mean? I don't think Hallmark's going to write that.
Right.
Great to see you.
Don't hug me too hard.
I won't.
Me and Howard are friends again, and I'm happy about that.
Seems like the feud is over, man.
It's just great. It's like being with an old friend, just picking up where you left off. That's how I really feel.
See you back on Stern.
It was good?
See you
hit all the time?
It was great. See you back.
All right.
Take care.
I'm so amped up from this.
That was awesome. It really was. You got mustard?
I think they'll want me back.
What do you think? The door is open, it seems, but it's really what you're going to do with it.
I'll call you later, all right?
All right, later, bro.
You know, I was just really happy to be there, and I really wanted to straighten it out because I missed the guy. Mm-hmm. That's why I told him, I said, I fought with you, but yet I'm driving around and listening to you. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And enjoying your show.
Right.
There's an amazing, amazing buzz around the whole thing.
I thought they went great.
I was up in Sirius today doing an NFL show, the NFL Network, and they were talking about it. For 10 minutes, we're supposed to talk football. The guy just wanted to talk about you being on Stern and how great it went. It was amazing. An hour and a half without a break. I think that's the most he's ever gone.
Yeah. You know.
But forget Rob. I thought she was going to come out of the booth and start banging right in the studio. I mean, she was like,
this is a television show.
What did I say?
This was some incredible day.
Do you need pickles?
I don't want no pickles.
I haven't eaten all day.
It's not about you, Todd. It's always
about my stomach.
We talked about this in the green
room.
It's
about my stomach.
When did I find? When?
I don't know. I have to tell you something, though. I was not hungry a short time ago. Your energy, what you did, the excitement, if I tell you now, I could probably eat half a dozen sandwiches.
I mean that.
Thank you.
Nice.
And some more extra rye bread.
Thank you.
It's going to be good.
Delicious.
The show, you were happy with the show, everybody?
Extremely happy.
Excellent.
What do you think?
No question.
I think Sirius Radio is a good forum for me because I'm not being censored in any way.
Absolutely.
The owner's going to pick up the check.
He saw your show, you know something? He should pick up the check.
Unbelievable.
You dumb. How about I come down there and knock the out of you? How would you like that? You'll be my bitch, ass face. You oversized cow. You slob. You.
They say I'm an angry comic. Well, let me tell you, how do you think it gets to this? It was one of the biggest shows of my career. I never thought it would turn out like this.
Well, you know what? Things are starting to roll. I even got a new camera right now.
Nice.
Yeah. You know, next week I'm going to go to Boston. It's very exciting. Big show in Boston.
First time ever on Sirius Radio, uncensored. Everybody's gonna be there. I'm gonna be there. Eleanor, my children, Uncle Lee, Todd, Wheels.
You know what? I don't care where you're going, but you gotta get rid of this garbage, Andrew.
No,
this is sickening. You can't leave this here.
I'm gonna do a garbage run right now. You wanna do it with me? We'll get one of my equipment here.
Garbage run. Great. That's what I mean.
This is a big show. We got me, we got Audie Lang. You know, it's gonna be a big deal show. This is a couple thousand seats. We're starting to heat up.
Yeah, it's good. Is this Audie Lang right on the cover here? It's not your boyfriend there?
See, this is what
are
I
you
mean.
Sure?
We're here to talk business, and you're no, playing. Looks... Wheels is the main road manager
okay.
on this
all right.
trip.
We'll work it out.
Everybody's got a job to do.
Okay, what's your job?
To make everybody laugh and make sure the show is great.
I'm waiting to laugh myself.
Look in the mirror. You'll laugh all day long, I promise. But I need you to be focused on this. Focus.
All right, so Wheels is the road manager. Don't lose track.
We'll figure out what we got to do. I'll let you know how everything's going to happen. I'll put the itinerary together.
I love Black Cherry. It's the best. But it's like you never get it unless you come to like a Jewish deli.
It's true. Nowhere else has it.
You know what I mean? Right?
It's the best. I love
it really is. Ah, yeah. Yeah, can we get this cleaned over here? Yeah, we got to move out. Move out. Get him up.
I got to go.
What is the rush? Where are you going?
Go. Got to feed the kids. I'll call you in a little bit.
The kids. If he ever had kids, there would have to be mercy killed. Wheels, he works for you.
Let's see how that works out.
I want to be able to take my boys to Boston with me for the show, but I got to be careful because in the past, you know, when I've asked their mom, I've sort of asked, you know, improperly.
You called your ex-wife an ass while the kids could hear it.
We were having an argument, and then I got mad, and I said, you know what? You are an ass.
Talk about an ass move. I guess you might not even be able to take them to Disneyland if you keep this up. Know who the ass is?
I'm the ass.
You got to understand that.
Tell her I'm sorry, which is, I'm sorry you're an ass.
Put a cork in it. Leave the Dice Man shtick for the stage. You got to separate the two. Can you do that for me?
Yes. But this time, everything's going to work out. Everything's going to go smooth and good. What are you doing, Big Shot? Are you working on something new?
Yeah.
Do me a favor. Come here, man. I got to talk to you. I know you were really looking forward to the trip to Boston, but I can't take you on this trip. Not this time. You know, this is Sirius Radio, and I can't have my son on the side of the stage when I'm, you know, just saying the most vicious things I could think of to somebody in the front row.
I guess.
I mean, believe me, I used to tell Max the same thing when he was your age. You can't watch, you can't listen. You know, he's 16, so he gets to go.
I still feel a little bad that I'm not going. But...
when you're older, you'll understand this stuff a little better.
Okay.
All right?
Yeah.
Hickory dickory dock, set your clock. This is Andrew Dice Clay, the undisputed heavyweight comedy king, coming to you this Saturday, live, uncensored, from the Hampton Beach Casino, 9 o'clock Eastern Time. There is only one comic, Dane Cook. What, are you kidding me? I f*** him. Oh!
Yeah, that was good. I like that one.
Don't look back at me. Look
Woo,
at the ball.
He's kicking.
Woo. Attaboy. Look how good he hits. You know what? If things don't work out with the guitar, we'll try to get you on a baseball group thing.
A team, babe.
Team, whatever. I'm not into sport. All right, one more and let her hit.
Woo.
All right, go ahead. Here comes the queen of the balls.
You're the king of the ball breakers.
You see that?
Can't even go anywhere. Hey, we got to make plans for Philadelphia.
Eleanor, I don't think I could make that trip.
What are you talking about, Andrew?
We'll talk about it later, that's all.
No, we already talked about it.
Eleanor, concentrate on what you're doing. All right.
You know what? I'm not doing this.
What are you getting mad about? I got to prepare for the Boston show.
What am I getting mad about, Andrew?
Eleanor, I got to
talk about this. It's 3 days. That's it.
But this is a big show.
You don't think my mother's birthday is important to me?
I love your mother. I love your family. But I have to be prepared. No, you don't understand. I mean, this is what I mean when I say you don't understand the big picture.
Well, I thought I was in this big picture with you.
You are.
I'm not. I'm always Bambi for you. I do everything for you. You can't do one thing for me. I'm always last on the list, and everything
else
is
warm. It's
not true. You just want to do what you want to do. And you know what?
That's
great.
I'm doing what I have to.
And I love you, but I can't do this anymore. I can't do it.
You know, she doesn't feel I'm giving her the time and attention, and... she's 100% right. We decided not to, you know, go out anymore. Where are you going? Let me just help with the
bags.
What's
help.
The big deal? You do need help.
Don't.
Please. Why didn't you just tell me you're going to do this today? When you break up with him, day before Thanksgiving, it's the best day of the year to break up with a chick. No, I meant to tell you when I got up, we're done. Like, yeah, this relationship is null and void. It's over. You can leave now. Like, yeah, I even bought you a ticket to go back home to your family where you could do most of your crying about it. With new luggage, because you've been so great with me. But this has to end. Now.
It's a lot of pressure riding on me.
I don't appreciate you calling Lee Lawrence an old man.
I don't care.
Who the f*** are you?
Who the f*** are you?
Well, that's time you learn a lesson.
It's 2:20-something in the morning. I just got done packing. I'm gonna lay down for a little while. It's a lot of pressure riding on me for this show. And I'm gonna deliver. I'm gonna destroy. I'm gonna make you laugh. I don't look like it right now, but I'm gonna make you laugh. Well,
yeah, he's got all the stuff in the car.
You want a piece of licorice?
You got any donuts or coffee?
I gotta get a coffee, man.
Listen to me. Come here. If I'm gonna give you this chance again, you gotta behave yourself.
No, I'm giving you this chance, my friend.
Okay, you're gonna behave?
Yes, I'm gonna behave. God bless. Let's get a coffee.
Todd, if you're gonna do anything, tell the driver not to tailgate, please.
Isn't Wheels the road manager right now?
Please, Todd.
Excuse me, can you please not tailgate and try to, you know, drive at a slower pace, sir? Thank you.
Already getting pre-show jitters. This is the first live satellite concert ever.
Wait a minute.
Huh.
What about Lee?
Well, that's what I'm saying. We have to wait.
Did he land?
20 minutes after us, he's supposed to be here.
Friggin' Lee again. I don't believe this again.
What?
The old man again. We're going to wait and wait around.
You're making fun of him.
I said we're waiting for Lee again.
You're calling him an old man, and he's not an old man.
Well, so what is he? That's not a put down. That's a nice thing. No. People age gracefully. He's a beautifully well-preserved older man.
And what are you? Let's see what you are.
No, let's see what you are.
No, I didn't call him an old man.
Let's see what you are. No, let's see what you are.
And that's That's someone that's very close to me.
Let's see what you.
He's not like you.
Yeah, but yeah. I'm not close to you.
He's not a bloodsucker.
Oh, okay.
I don't appreciate you calling Lee Lawrence an old man.
I don't care.
You've been doing nothing.
I've been doing nothing in my life. You don't know what I've
You acted like an The minute we got here,
I'm gonna pay you what you pay me, and you do what I do.
What are you saying? You're not paid enough?
That's right.
That's another big problem.
You're not a listener.
Yours.
No, you
I
are.
Give you another chance.
I gave
to come
you a
here
chance.
And being involved in
chance
this. And you're acting
I
like
gave
an ass.
You a chance.
To do what?
To have someone around that's not kissing your ass 24 hours. What do you want?
Oh, is that what
you
this
got
is?
Yeah.
Who the f are you?
Who the f
would
you?
I want to know?
And who the f are you?
Oh, you know who I am? It's time you learn
to
let.
Seriously.
It's time you learn a lesson, really.
Forget it, then.
You're
it. You don't want to listen.
Day.
All right, go. You're leaving now. Get on the next plane.
It's okay. Your balls are as shriveled up as your hair follicles.
Yeah, you would know, because you're the one trying to
you're
for the
right
last 10 years.
Yeah, whatever.
What I have to do here is important for us. And I'm not going to let anybody come between that.
I had a fight today with who I call my best friend. There are no friends. Don't you see the scenario? This guy's with a wife and the tag-along friend. You know, the girl he's been wanting to since day one. He's going, and I'm with you? Why didn't you tell me the friend's got bigger? You really believe she's your friend? There are no friends. I mean, my best friend, he only wants money. That's all he wants. You know what she wants? Your
I thought everybody was going to be here for the big show. But now me and Eleanor are done. And I don't even know if Uncle Lee's gonna make it.
But I've been screwing up lately. I'm a very high-strung, stressed-out, anxiety-ridden person. You know, I don't hold back. I say what's on my mind.
But I have to have a clear focus. I have to be very, very focused. The show, it is the absolute biggest challenge.
Now it's time to work. Now it's time to get it done.
The show's just going to be absolute mayhem. It's going to be a massacre. It's going to be insanity.
The percentage of people are going to be listening to this show is going to be unbelievably high.
You slob! You oversized cow! You fatso!
Show's just gonna be absolute mayhem. It's gonna be a massacre. It's gonna be insanity.
Nice, Jackie, nimble, Jackie, quick, Jack, burn off this.
How you doing? Good to see you again.
Did you have to walk first?
Yeah, it's crazy.
It's crazy.
How you
doing?
Going on? Are you good with me bringing you up, or how do you want to
come on.
9 o'clock, it'll be 20 minutes or whatever into my set.
I'll
say, look, well, now we're live on Sirius. Playing out, like, you know, it was a thrill for me because I was such a big
fan. Yeah, you know what
Dice,
to do.
And, like,
then my music will kick in.
Wheels.
Do your job. You know, with the left-hand cutoff?
Gotcha.
Go over it with him.
I will.
And make sure to hit me with a spotlight when I come up there.
Yeah, we're doing the ballyhooing too, right?
Yes, you know the way. You're doing it for 20 years. 20 years.
I know the left-hand cutoff from seeing you back in the
day.
But
you'd think he'd know after about 30,000 shows.
So I should say, look, guys, get ready. In just a little bit, you're going to see Dice, right? So that'll be them.
Dice will be up in a minute.
Okay, great. All right, go.
All right, we're on the same page, team. Go team.
Okay, when the ballyhooing light starts, the walk-on music will go on, okay? And at that point, you got to catch him with the spot. When you get a left-hand cutoff like this, you hit it immediately. No fading. As soon as he goes like that, on this hand going out, is dead.
All right.
I'm going to go just grab a little something to eat because I have my lower, man. It's crazy.
Getting ready.
get myself some protein.
I don't care what this is. That's how hungry I am.
Serious. The percentage of people that listen to the channels that are going to be listening to this show is going to be unbelievably high.
I'm always last on the list. I can't do this anymore. Can't do it.
Change everybody's mind that you're still funny.
Well, there's a difference between dreams and fantasies.
Listen to me. If anybody could do this, it's you.
You have it inside of you. You will be the greatest again.
Which brings us back to this fat. You should meet my mother. That's when you know you're gonna bang a chick, but you know what I'm thinking when they say that? You dummy. Your mother? Why would you want me to see what you are slowly but surely going to decay into? Why would you want me to see 30 or 40 years down the road when your ass is... You know, wait, there's one guy just begging for attention. You know, bend over, hey, I your mother in the and she had your fatso, you oversized cow, you slob, you that's what I do. Does he think he is? That's the dice you want. That's the dice you get. I'm the Punisher. This is dice. This is living the dice dream. You hear that? You hear the sound of that crowd? And that's only 2,000 people. You see, the first time around, back then, there were a lot of people that said, oh, it's never going to happen. But it did happen. And now we're on the way again. Tonight it's 2,000. Before you know it, it's 5, 10, 50. There might have been a lot of doubters, but you know it's going to happen. Am I ever going to take no for an answer? No way.